Day two of beekeeping, 4D honeybee. I brought those two nucs here yesterday, but it was really cold. It was like 4 degrees Celsius, about 40 Fahrenheit. So I just dropped them off there, let them orient themselves. It looks like one hive is a lot more active than the other right now. Have a look here, we'll zoom in. One compared to the other looks a lot quieter. So it's a little warmer now with the sunshine. It's still only about 8 degrees Celsius, about high 40s in Fahrenheit, but I'm going to move them over to their permanent hives today, and hopefully it all goes well. So here's another view of how different the hives are as far as activity. This one's really a buzzing. This one's a lot quieter. No idea why, but we're gonna work on this white one first, get it in, and then we'll do the other one. Okay, first thing, we're gonna remove the lid. We've got one deep and a super on top of here, which is just protecting the top feeder that we're going to have on. So we'll get rid of all this. And we've got the inner cover here that is vented. That too. Now we've got six frames in here because it's a four frame nuc. But I'm going to take one frame out as well. They're wax-filled wooden frames. I'm going to take one frame out when we do the insertion of the new frames, just so that there's more room to work with inside the hive. I'm going to spray these frames up with one-to-one sugar water as well, just in the hopes that it'll help them draw it out faster. Sweeten everything up. One bee in there already. Come to your new home. That's it for now. So now we've got the smoker going here. I will smoke up this hive and inspect all the frames as I put them in. And hopefully it'd be nice to see a queen and to see some good sign of brooding and that kind of thing. And we'll see how it goes from there. So I'm gonna smoke in front of it, and I'm gonna smoke the top as well. And these seem to be nice and calm. Hopefully they'll stay that way, of course. Just let the smoke sit there for a bit, and then we'll pull out frame by frame and see what we've got. Looks really good. Some bird comb already set up on the box. There's some dew in there as well, so they probably weren't getting very good ventilation. Look at the water coming out. That's never good for the bees, so I'm glad that I'm taking them out now. Just set this down here for now. we'll start working on the frames. We'll put the frames in the same order as they come out, and hopefully we'll see some cleaning and some activity. Okay, it's a really nice looking frame. They've got honey all around the outside of it, capped honey, which is good. And let's see if I can see down inside. Lots of honey inside the combs. Not sure that I see any eggs though. It looks really good. I'm gonna look for a queen here. I'll start looking on the outside. Come back around to the middle. I don't know if I'll find the queen, but consider it a bonus if I do. It's just nice to see a really good frame here. Nice to see some eggs in there. I don't see any eggs. I'd say most of the empty cones, most of the cones have honey in them. A few don't. And wow, this side is all capped honey. That's interesting. This is definitely no brood here. So, neat to see. Nice and calm. Looks like I don't see a queen here either. So the first frame goes in. Second frame looks like it's even more full than the first. Let's see what we got here. Just smoke them down a little bit off the top. It's easier to grab with a squish. Okay. Again, here a lot of capped honey. Looks like this is just burr comb. I don't see this as being anything like a swarm cell or anything like that. So. Get rid of some of this burr comb. Oh, that was a swarm cell there. Gotta get rid of that. Let's get rid of this thing too. It's definitely, possibly a swarm cell. Now let's see if we can see the queen on here. Let's see what we've got. Again, capped honey all around the outside. I don't see any eggs inside the combs there yet on this one. Let's bring it around to the other side. And again, the honey around the outside is really good. I don't think I see the queen. like there's a lot of drones here, actually. There's some bees that are substantially bigger than other bees.
That's interesting.
Yeah, there's definitely drones here. So there. I'll get rid of this burr comb when I put it back in. Stuff up here because I'll just stick it to the lid. I'll stick the frame to the lid using this burr comb. I don't want that to happen. Okay, so next frame is probably where I'd expect to see the queen if I was gonna see her. Because she usually hangs out in the middle, so I understand. Guys. Lots of drones, lots of bigger bees here than in the other. And, oh, there's the queen. She is a marked queen. Look, Queen Isabel. Let's see if you can see Queen Isabel there. She's marked in pink right there in the middle. Do you see her? See her, Isabel? That's good. I didn't know this queen was going to be marked. That is awesome. That makes me very happy. So let's see what Queen Isabel is up to here. Where'd she go? Now here we do see eggs and larvae at various stages. That makes perfect sense because here's where the queen is, right? And she is inspecting everything and doing her duty. See if I can see her drop an egg. Oh. Nice, okay, let's get her in. It's nice to see the queen at work there. We'll take off this burr comb at the top as well. The smoke is going. The smoker might have died out. Okay, let's get this smoker working. this one in, and then we'll relight the smoker for the next hive, because it's not doing so well. Alright, let's get this last frame in. Now that you've seen the queen and seen that she's happy and marked, that's a great sign, nice bonus. The breeder said the queen wouldn't be marked, so I'm pleasantly surprised. This is another frame of nicely capped honey. Some bird comb on the bottom there. You can see the nice pattern around the outside, sort of a semicircle of capped honey. And they're just starting to put honey on the rest of the combs there as well. Looks like a very healthy colony, so hopefully you can keep them. Okay, let's get them in and get them fed. And then, so again, on this one, we'll be extra careful when we merge the frames here so that we know the queen's on this side here. So that's why it was nice having the extra space on the frames, so that we're less likely to squish them. Now we bring these two frames together and put in this frame here, which was the extra one, and just center them all in the middle, make sure they're nice and straight and parallel. So that's the way bees like it, I understand. And we're in good shape. I'll set this box down. There's just a couple of bees in there, a lot of bee parts and garbage and stuff, but the bees that are in there will find their way into their proper new home for sure. Okay. Now we'll get the lid on, get the feeder on, and hive number one is almost done. Looks like the smoker's come back to life too. The feeder just goes right in the middle, and I'm going to fill it with 1-to-1 water to sugar. Some people do 2-to-1 at this early time, but right now we've got a pretty good flow on for dandelions and such, so I'll feed them for as long as they keep eating it, but some say you don't even need to feed them at all. So. Should keep them from drowning in it. They'll come up through the inner lid and crawl down the inside of that cup and make themselves to their heart's content. I hope. That's pretty good. Get down on them, and hive number one is done. So we're on to hive number two now, and this one the bees are a lot more active, so I wanted to make sure I got the smoker going. It seems to be going pretty well now. It was just a second ago. Yeah, it seems to be okay now. Bring the sugar water over. We'll bring the sugar water spray over as well. Oh yeah, I can definitely smell that we're now into burning the wood chips. So that's good. The smoker should be working good. I'll do a little more prep work for this hive because it's duct tape shut. So we've got to just cut the duct tape away. You know what, I'm going to spray them right now so they can hopefully start to relax a little. Definitely see that these are a lot more active than the other ones. So nothing to worry about, they're just taking care of business. I'll spray under the lid here and calm them down a little bit, hopefully. Wow, this hive is really less happy than the other one. As soon as we opened up the lid, they became really active, really loud. So we'll see how she goes. And the top super just houses the feeder. Get rid of all this and we'll bring it back in a sec. Sugar water, we'll leave one frame out so that we don't crowd as much. Yes, these bees are significantly less happy than the first hive, it seems. Hopefully it's just because it was really cold overnight. This is their first time flying in this area, obviously. So hopefully that's what's causing them to be a little more on the agitated side. You could definitely hear it as soon as you open the lid. They just became a roaring engine of buzzing in there. Okay, so we'll smoke them up now and see how she goes. Wow. They're not happy bee campers. Wow, you put the smoke on them and they just go berserk. So let's try not to smoke them anymore and see how it goes. Lots of bird comb on this one too. It's very fresh because they haven't been in that box for that long. So. Okay, so this one is on wax as well, and they're just starting to build out this frame with comb. See, it's still only maybe, I don't know, 20% built out, I'd say. This side's a little better, let's call it maybe 40, 50% built out, so that's good, they're doing there. Just tell the difference in weight from a frame that is really filled in to a frame that isn't. It's like one's feather light and the other one's quite heavy. You have to think about how you hold it. Okay, next frame, really nice full frame. Lots of cat brood here, which is good. See if, ooh, lots of drones working around. See if we can see a queen. Again, I don't know if it's marked or not, but I'll start looking around the outside and work my way in. Wow. Getting lots of honey on the outside. Still a lot of work to be done on this frame too, but it's in there. Nice looking frame. Okay, again, this is a newer frame, so I'm wondering if the queen would be on this one, but we'll see. It looks like they put in two new frames with two old frames to help build it out. Just be extra careful here. I'm going to lift this up. And we're looking for Queen Matica in this hive. That's what I've named her for my daughters. Wow, some big drones here. Amazing the size difference between the drones. There's a lot of young bees here, so it's a good sign. Lots of bees that can't be more than a few days old. You can see they're gorging themselves on the honey because of the smoking that was done. See up in the upper right corner here, just got their faces right in the honeycomb, sucking up honey. See that? So I don't see the queen here, but who knows? Let's check out the other side now. I'm seeing larvae in those combs, which is nice. This side. And lots of fresh honey on it, lots of cat brood. Don't know if I see a queen or not. Well, I definitely don't see a queen, but there's a good sign that there's one in there. Okay, next and final frame. It'd be nice to see the queen on here, but wouldn't be too upset if she's not, because we have seen lots of good sign. So we'll start on the inside. And this is all a honey frame. Don't see any capped brood yet. Spot a queen. They're all just drinking away there because of the smoking. So hopefully once I let them go, they'll calm back down and get back to business. Lots of drones here too. Oh, could that be the queen? No, that's a big drone. Let's try this side. Looked like that second frame was the best as far as larva and that kind of thing. And no positive identification on the queen on this one. Lots of activity in the lower right corner here, but I don't necessarily see a queen. Okay, so we'll put this back in and let them calm down. Slide them over so gently, bring in that frame that we took out, and then just space them properly. It's looking good. Wow, there's a ton of bees in here. danger here is that the queen might be in this side here. So I'm going to just look at it for a bit, see if I can see her. I think what I'll do with this side is I'll spray these guys down in sugar water, and then drop them into the hive. Didn't have to do that with the other one because there weren't many bees stuck on the box, but just in case she's in here, I want to make sure she goes in the box. Just spraying them down with sugar water so they're less likely to fly if their wings are covered with water. Now we're going to see a lot of buzzing right now. And the rest will just lay out in front here. Let them find their own way home. I'll start putting the covers on and calling it a wrap. Get rid of the smoker now. Somebody told me, he gave me good advice. Be careful where you put down the smoker, especially in arid, dry climates, because you could start a fire with it. So here it's okay. We're nice and wet and nice and cool, but just be something to think about. Okay, so put the top cover back on with the upper escape and vent. Make sure we're not squishing any one of them. Move over, buddy. Move over. Feeder going, and that's that. Just center the feeder on the hole and pour in your juice. Liters. I don't know what that is in gallons, but we'll just see how they're taking it. Again, there is a good honey flow on with dandelions around, but my plan is just to feed them as long as they're taking the sugar water. Once they stop it, then I'll stop, but I want to try and give them every advantage we can. Oh, there's a guy going for a swim. Come on out, buddy. There you go. Okay, and this medium, which is really a super for honey, just goes on top to protect the feeder. A friend was asking me about that on a picture I sent him of my setup, why I had the supers on already. Okay, so that's it. Two established colonies, my first time ever doing bees, and hopefully it'll turn out all right. Thanks for joining me at 4D Honeybee. Talk to you soon.